In this video, we'll make a very simple GUI using Eclipse that adds and subtracts numbers. First, I'm going to install Window Builder. The directions from the website didn't work for me, but the following process did. From the Help menu, pick Install New Software. In the Work With, type HTTP, then double-click to select Juno, or whatever version you have. Mine is http://download.eclipse.org/releases/juno. Click the triangle to the left to expand General Purpose Tools, then scroll down and check Swing Designer, all the SWT designers except XWT, all the Window Builder cores, and Window Builder Group Layout support. Push Next. Eclipse will modify the request slightly. Push Next again, accept the terms of the license agreement, and push Finish. Now click Yes to restart Eclipse to complete the installation. We get a welcome screen, which I'll close, and we're ready to create the user interface. From the File menu, pick New, then Project. Now, on the wizard screen, we have a new section for Window Builder. I'll expand that, then SWT Designer, then SWT/JFaceJavaProject. When I push Next, it asks for the name of the project. I'll call this Calculator and press Finish. I now right-click on the new project, pick New and Other. I'll expand Window Builder, then SWT Designer, then SWT, then select Application Window and push Next. I need to give the class a name, for example Calc, and hit Finish. At this point, I have a main class with a main method. Clicking on the Design tab, I can now create my GUI. In the middle, you'll see a large palette of things I can add to my application. We'll need places to enter the numbers, so I'll add two text controls. I click on the text control, then place it in the window. After clicking text control again to place the second, you'll note that Eclipse helps me line up the two boxes. Now I can click on the right edge and make them bigger. Again, Eclipse helps me make the second one the same size as the first. A good user interface will tell the user what they are supposed to put in the boxes. So I'll add a couple of labels. I can type the text for the label right away. I'll type first number, then resize the label to make it big enough. For the second, I'll click away so I can show how to change the text later. To the left, I have a section for properties. I can scroll down in this and change the text from new label to second number. Scrolling up to bounds, I can change the width manually to 100 instead of using the mouse. Eclipse allows me to change the GUI either using the designer or by writing Java code. Switching to source view, I'll change the window title. It was SWT application, but I'll change it to simple calculator. When I go back to design view, you'll see the preview of the window has the new title. Next, I'll add a couple of buttons for addition and subtraction. I'll change these so they display plus and minus. Back in the properties, you'll see tooltip text, which is what is displayed when you hover over the button with the mouse. I'll add some text here saying add and subtract. Now, I need a place for the answer. Again, I'll use a label. I set the text to the answer is. The answer is pretty important, so I'll make the font bigger. In the Properties area, scrolling to Font, I click on the three dots, which brings up a dialog where I can select a font type, style, and size. Let's go with Script, Bold, and 24-point font. I'll now drag the right edge over to show the whole text, and leave space on the right to make room for the answer. Okay, now we're ready to make something happen when they push a button. First, I'll change the name of the variable for the button to something more meaningful, like plus button. Remember, by convention, you don't capitalize the first letter of a variable name in Java. Instead of using the properties, this time I'll use the components list under structure and right-click on each and select rename. I'll go ahead and give meaningful names to the two text fields and the answer label. Double-clicking on the plus button brings me back to Source View, where it has created a method to fill in the code that will be run when the button is pushed. I'll add code to parse the text from the two text fields into integer variables. Since the user might not type a valid number, I'll add a try-catch block. If the number is bad, I'll display an error dialog. This can be done with the static method messageDialog.OpenError. The parent is shell, the message will be bad first number, and the title will be error. Eclipse shows an error with the light bulb and red X since the messageDialog class has not been imported. Eclipse will automatically resolve the error for me if I click and then double-click on the choice to add the import. If the user typed invalid input, I want to return and not try to compute an answer. Now I can copy and paste this and do the second number. I need to change the error message, the variable name, and also which text field I'm reading. Now I can make the answer be number 1 plus number 2. But I have an error again. This is because number 1 and number 2 were declared inside the try-catch blocks, and go away when the try-catch is over. To fix this, I'll declare number 1 and number 2 at the beginning of the method. Now we're almost done. All that's left is to display the answer. I'll set the text of the answer field. Now Eclipse gives me an error. I see the light bulb with the red X to the left. Answer label is not visible at this point. This is because it appears lower in the method. I'll cut and paste that higher in the code. There's still an error, though. Now it says that answer label may not be referred to in this method unless it is changed to be final. The quick fix solves that problem. Now I can switch back to design view and do the same for minus. Copy and paste the code, and change the plus to minus. Now we'll run the program. If I type in text instead of a number and push plus, I get the error. But if I put in a couple of good numbers, then the right thing happens. You can download the source for this project at java.martincarlyle.com.